In this video, I'm going to tell you what is threading, how and when to use it in Python. So keep watching. Hi there, welcome to Saral Gyan. In the previous video, we learned about multiprocessing. We also learned about the synchronous and asynchronous tasks. If you haven't yet watched that video, watch it first to have a better grasp on threading. As I told in the last video, threading is suitable for I/O bound tasks, which involve reading files, downloading files, etc. Unlike multiprocessing, threading doesn't overcome GIL, but in this, the process is started concurrently when the CPU is waiting for one task. Now I will first show you an example of using threading in old way and then the new way using pool executors, and thereafter we will be using threading in a real world example in which we will download certain PDF files from a website. So let's start coding. So first of all, we will import time so that we can add the sleep time, and then we will be doing start is equal to time dot time, and then we will define a function, define print underscore square, and it will take a number. We will be adding a sleep time, time dot sleep one, and then we will be doing print f number squares is number square. We saying and is equal to time dot time, and here we will be printing it took round off and minus start comma 2 seconds, and we need to add curly braces here for f strings, and now we will run it for two numbers. And if you see, it took 2 seconds. Now we will be importing OS module and we will be printing the process ID. So here we will be saying print the process ID is os.getPID, and if we run it now, so here if you have a look, the process ID is same for both the functions. It means when we run this script, both the functions are running synchronously and the second function is waiting for the first one to finish. So now we will use threading. Firstly, we will be using the old method, which involves a longer code, but this will help you understand it better. Later on, we will be moving to the new method using the pool executors. So we will be doing the imports, and here we will be doing from threading import thread. And since threading is an inbuilt module, you don't need to install anything. And here we will be creating two threads. T1 is equal to thread, and then you have to define the target function, which is here print underscore square, and we don't want to execute it, so we are not adding the braces here. And then we will be passing the argument as a list, args is equal to 2, and then we'll be copying it, and this would be our T2, and here the argument will be 3, and we will delete these lines, and then we will be doing t1.start and t2.start. And if you run it now, here it has printed this line before the print statements. This is because when one of the method was running, it moves to the another one and eventually moves to the last statement. But this is not what we want. So we will be using t1.join and t2.join here so that the function waits for both the processes to end before reaching the last line. So now if we run it, so now it took only 1 second, which is half of the time which it took for normal process. And if you have a closer look at the process IDs, the process ID here is same, which is different from multiprocessing, because in threading, the threads are running concurrently, and while one of the thread is waiting for the sleep time, the other thread run. Now if you want to run it for 10 times, here we will have to do threads is an empty list, and then for I in range 1 to 11, we'll move it here, and then T will be equal to thread and args will be equal to I doing T dot start, and then we will be appending each thread to the list, and lastly we will be doing for thread in threads thread dot join, and if you run it, so it took 1 second for all the processes to end. So in this example, we created the threads manually and then ran them. Now we will be moving to the another method where we will use thread pool executor, which will make it easier to run threading with fewer lines of code. Thread pool executor is not a part of threading module and it is in concurrent.futures. So we don't need this anymore, and we will be doing import concurrent.futures, and after our function here, we don't need this line, so we will be commenting them out. And after our function here, we will be doing with concurrent.futures.threadpoolexecutor as executor, T is equal to executor dot submit print square, and then passing the argument, and we'll be doing T1 is equal to, and then T2 will be equal to this, and then to run it we will be doing dot result T2 dot result. So if you run it now, so both the processes took only 1 second. Now let's say you want to run it for 10 times. So for that we will be creating a list, numbers is equal to range 1 to 11, and then here we will be using the list comprehension. So results is equal to executor dot submit, and then print underscore square comma number for number in numbers, and then we will be doing for f in concurrent dot few dot as completed results f dot result. And if you run it now, all the 10 processes took only 1 second. Since time.sleep is more of a IO bound task, as the CPU is just sleeping and waiting, it took way more less time than the multiprocessing, where it took 3 seconds for 10 processes. Instead of using this, we can also use the map function, and for that we will have to do results is equal to executor dot map, and then we'll be doing print underscore square, and then we will be mapping the list of the numbers, and here we will be doing for result in results result. So here it also took 1 second for 10 processes. So now we will try to implement threading in a real world example. To see threading in action, we will be choosing a IO bound task, and for that I will be using a part of the code which we used in a previous video where we downloaded the PDF file from the Springer's website. So this is the code which I have already written, and let me walk you through it. So I have imported request, time and concurrent futures, then I have set the start time, and then I have a list of 5 links from where we can download the PDF files, and then I am looping through that list and then downloading each file and saving it on my system. Here I have calculated the end time, and then we have printed the same. So if we run it, so it is time and not times. So let's save it and run it again. Let's see how much time will it take. So it has taken 33.32 seconds. And if you have a look at the folder, these four files have been downloaded. Now we will be using threading. So here, instead of this line, we will be making it a function. And this function will be taking two arguments, I and link. I will give the name to the file. And here we will be doing with concurrent.futures.threadpoolexecutor. executor dot map download book, and the argument one would be range of 5 and the other one would be download underscore links. And let's delete the old files. And if we save it and if we run it again, so it says executor is not defined. Here we have to make it small. And if you run it again, so it took just 2.9 seconds and all our files have been downloaded. So the threading has made the time taken from 33 seconds to 2.9 seconds. Now let's see how much time multiprocessing will take for this process. So we will do process here and we will again delete these files. And if we run it now, it has taken 4.59 seconds, which is twice the time taken by threading. It means for IO processes, threading is a better option to use rather than multiprocessing. This is it for this video. If you have any doubt, leave it in the comment section below and I will try my best to resolve it. If you have enjoyed our video, please hit the like button and share it with someone who might find it helpful. If you haven't yet subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon for future notifications. Bye-bye for now. Take care.